Morning, guys. How are we feeling today?
Good.
Feeling good? You guys remember what we went over last week?
Yes.
All right, we're going over the squats. Proper form, what we're looking for in the squats, right? Okay. Who can tell me something that we learned about the squat last week?
Thought of hamstring.
It is, you're putting some strain on the hamstrings, right? What's another muscle in the leg we're using?
Calves.
Calves are important for stability. What's a big muscle in the front? That extends the knee. Remember, we stretch those out every time.
Quad
stretch. There we go. Those are the quads. All right. And that stretch we did yesterday. Remember, we were on the baseball.
Yeah.
Okay, those are the glutes. Glute stretch. Okay, those are the main muscles that are incorporated in the squat. Right. Okay. Now with our squat form, we're looking for a few things. Right. We're looking to make sure our heels stay flat on the ground, our hips stay back, so our center of gravity is over our feet. Okay, not too much pressure on the knees, right? How do we want our back to look with the squat? We want that back flat, right? We keep that back flat by keeping our chest out, keeping our head up, right? So that's what we did last week. Okay, now today we're gonna be going over what it looks like to spot somebody with that. Now, spotting somebody for a lift is a safety procedure that you do to allow them to be able to lift a weight that they're not comfortable lifting. Right, so if somebody's gonna max out, somebody's gonna lift a bigger weight than they're used to doing, it's good to have somebody to have their back, right? To make sure they don't get hurt, make sure they feel comfortable while they're doing it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
All right, so in order to do a good spot for somebody, you gotta make sure you're close to them, you gotta make sure you're ready to help them, you gotta know what you're looking for when they need your help.
Right?
So say they come down with the squat, and they pause and they struggle and they can't get back up and they start leaning forward. I think that might be a key sign that they might need your help.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're looking for little things like that to tell us if we need to be helping them back up. All right. So to do this, okay, we're gonna start out by splitting up into a few groups. All right. Okay, one person's gonna be lifting, one person's gonna be spotting. All right, I'm gonna be observing while you guys are doing that to make sure you guys are looking for the right cues. All right, make sure you're noticing what he's doing. All right. And to make sure we're using the right technique for the spot. All right? So when we've been out there before, when we're benching, okay, we've had a spotter on either side, spotter on both sides of the barbell. Well, when you only have one spotter, you can't just spot one side because it's gonna tip it, it's gonna knock the weights off, it's gonna dump on the floor, right? So there's a different technique that you wanna use to be able to be a solo spotter, all right? So can I have some volunteers stand up for me?
There we go.
All right, so facing the front board, okay, barbell on back. If I'm on the side right here and I'm helping up this side, what's gonna happen to the other side? That's going down. So if we only have one spotter, that's not how it works, right? Okay, so go ahead and show me a good squat.
This way? Or this way?
Facing this way. Well, let's face sideways so I can get a better angle on you. All right. Okay, he's keeping his back flat, he's keeping his chest up. Okay, his heels came up a little bit, and that's why his knees were popping, right? When your heels come up, you put too much pressure on your knees, right? So sit back for me on this next squat. There, that was a little better. All right, so if I can't just spot one side, where do I need to be to help him out? You gotta be right behind him, right? There's a bunch of different ways to do this, but the safest way is double underhooks. So if he goes down, go ahead and squat. We're here, we're ready. All right, and if he can't get up, we come in right underneath the armpits and we scoop him up and we squat with him. So he doesn't give up, he's still pushing, but we're underneath there and we're helping him up. All right, now there's some old school ways to do it. Go ahead and get back in your position. Older ways would be one hand across the chest and one hand on the lower back, because a lot of times they'll wanna, watch out real quick. If the weight's too much for him, a lot of times they'll bend over. So an old method was to keep them in a good position while they come up so they can have a better position for their own squat. But what that tended to do was actually push the hips forward, which made the heels come up and put too much pressure on the knees. So it actually made it a bad form and a dangerous squat. So now what we like to do is we like to get that double underhook. All right? All right, so Mike, come up here for us real quick. Go ahead and give us a demo squat again. I want to see where we're at with Mike. Yeah, demo squat. Yes, sir.
Same squat I just did?
Yeah, same thing. Yeah, we'll have my spot you right now.
Oh.
There we go.
You ready, Mike?
We're good, yeah, so we're staying close to him. Slow down, slow down. Good, and we only get in there if he needs us. So if he starts falling or his heels are coming up, that's when we get in there and we help him up. The closer we are to him, the better. All right, one last try. Cool. All right. You feel safe there, Schaefer? Mike got your back. So based off the exercise we just did, do you guys feel confident with what I expect you to do when we're going to actually spot each other with a barbell on the back?
Yes.
You guys feel you understand what I'm looking for?
No.
All right. Now, last thing, do you guys have any soreness or tightness, any injuries that I should know about?
No.
Nothing. Nothing's banged up from soccer earlier or anything? All right. Well, let's get in groups and let's start doing it.